Now this is question number 68, code C of the physics paper. The question reads that the particle is moving a circular path under the action of attractive potential, and the potential is potential energy is U is equal to minus K by twice R square. Okay, and you are asked to calculate the total energy. Total energy. Now we know that total energy, it is sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. Okay, and information about potential energy was given, and from this we need to find the expression for kinetic energy. Okay, so see, for that what we need to do is you find a relation between force and potential energy. Now for conservative force, F is equal to minus du by dr. Okay, so that is minus d by dr of minus k by 2r square. Okay, so that gives force is equal to k by r cube. Okay, so this is the expression for force. Now since the particle is moving in a circular path, so this force is providing the centripetal force, so that is equal to mv square by r. Okay, so this rr cancels out, so we have mv square is equal to k by r square. So mv square by 2 is equal to k by 2r square. So this is the expression for kinetic energy. Potential energy is also is minus k by 2r square. So if you substitute the value of kinetic energy and potential energy, this answer comes out to be 0. So for question number 68, the correct option is number 2. So for 68, question number 68, the correct option is number 2. The answer is 0. Question number 69 is a formula based question wherein you are asked to calculate the magnitude of induced charge. So you have to use the formula that Q induced, it is equal to K minus 1 into CV. Okay, so if you substitute the values, this comes out to be around 1.2 nano coulomb. So for question number 69, the correct answer is option 4. So option 4 is the correct answer for question number 69. So question number 70 is a formula based question wherein we are asked to calculate the force constant. Frequency is given. So F is equal to 1 by twice pi square root of K by M. Okay, so here M is the mass of the silver atom. Okay, so mass of the silver atom, that can be calculated as, because molecular mass, molecular weight is already given. So M is equal to 108 gram, it is given in gram. So 108 into 10 power minus 3 kg, so divide by 6.023 into 10 power 23. Okay, so now if you this frequency is given to be 10 power 12, so 10 power 12 is equal to 1 by twice pi square root of K divided by this value of M. Okay, now on solving this value, this K comes out to be 7.1 newton per meter. Okay, so for question number 70, the correct option is number 1. Okay, so next is question number 71. The question reads that when neutron suffers elastic collision with deuterium, when neutron undergoes collision with deuterium, the fractional loss of energy is Pd. Okay, but when this neutron undergoes collision with carbon, the fractional loss of energy is Pc. Okay, so we are asked to calculate the value of this Pd and this Pc. Okay, now basically if you apply the conservation, see, in all types of collision momentum is always conserved. Okay, so this first case, you have a neutron undergoing collision with deuterium. So neutron, if this mass is m, deuterium the mass will be twice m. okay, and initially the deuterium is at rest, so initial momentum is due to momentum of the motion of this neutron. So if you apply conservation momentum, we have mv naught is equal to mv1 plus twice mv2, okay, where v1 and v2 are the velocities of this neutron and deuterium. So from this we have v0 is equal to v1 plus 2v2. Okay, now this is, it is an elastic collision, coefficient of restitution is 1, so e is equal to 1. Okay, so that gives v2 minus v1 is equal to v0, that is relative velocity after collision is equal to relative velocity before collision, because coefficient of restitution is 1. So on solving these two, you can calculate the value of v2 and v1. Okay, now if you solve this value, the v2 comes to be around twice v0 by 3 and v1 comes to be around minus v0 by 3. Okay, I have already solved these equations, so I am writing this equation directly. Now fractional loss of kinetic energy is fractional loss of kinetic energy. First case is half mv0 square minus half mv1 square divided by initial energy, half mv0 square. Now v1 is v0 by 3. Okay, so this is fractional loss of kinetic energy in the first case for deuterium. Okay, so this, if you substitute all these values, this value comes to be around 0.89. Okay, so option 1 and option 4 both has this quantity 0.89. okay, but option 4 only has PD is equal to first term as 0.89. remember this PD is 0.89, so option 4 should be the correct answer. Okay, now let us check for, if you check for second case also, when this neutron undergoes collision with carbon, so when neutron undergoes collision with carbon, so for this, if mass is m, for this mass will be twice 12 times m. Okay, so if you apply conservation of momentum, it will be mv0 is equal to mv1 plus 12 mv2. Okay, and for coefficient of restitution e is equal to 1, we have v0 is equal to v2 minus v1. Okay, so again on solving these two, you can calculate the value of v2 and v1. Okay, now this v2 comes out to be around 2v0 by 13 and v1 comes to be around minus 11 v0 by 13. So the fractional loss of kinetic energy in this case, it will be half m v0 square minus half m v1 square divided by again half m v0 square. So this is the fractional loss of kinetic energy of the neutron. Okay, now this, what is v1? V1 is minus 11 v0 by 13. So on substituting this, we get 0.28. So it is confirmed that option D, option 4, is the correct answer for question number 71. Now question number 72, it's reached that the dipole moment of a circular loop carrying a current I is M. Okay, and the magnetic field at the center is B1. When the dipole moment is doubled, keeping the current constant, the magnetic field at the center is B2. So you are asked to calculate the ratio of B1 and B2. Now dipole moment M is equal to I into A. Okay, now this A is area of the circular loop, so it is I into pi r square. Okay, now in this case the magnetic field is B1 when the radius is r. So magnetic field at the center of a circular loop is mu naught I by twice r. Okay, now when the dipole moment is doubled, keeping the current constant, so when the dipole moment is doubled, so it is twice m, when keeping the current constant means area is doubled. Okay, if dipole moment is doubled, current is constant, that means obviously area is doubled. So if the area is doubled, if r prime or r dash is the new radius, then it means this is equal to this twice a, it is equal to pi r dash square. Okay, but what is this a? A is this quantity pi r square. So this is 2 into pi r square is equal to pi r dash square. So that gives r dash is equal to root 2 r. root 2 r. Now, as you can see, keeping the current constant, current is kept constant in the entire situation. So magnetic field is this, it is inversely proportional to the radius if the current is constant. So that means B1 by B2 is equal to r dash divided by r. So r dash divided by r, from this it is root 2 by 1. So the correct option is number 4. For 72, the correct option is number 4.